Welcome to my next video here, where I'm going to discuss the layers of the heart. This is for the Bio 4 Human Anatomy class at Cabrillo College during the Corona Spring. Okay, so I have three really spectacular pictures here I've downloaded off the internet. And it's really important when we're downloading anything off the internet to post to our students, or really to post anywhere, that we determine whether or not we can actually download those and they are labeled for reuse, which all three of these were labeled for reuse. So I'm thankful for that, because there are some really great pictures of the heart and related structures. On picture A is a spectacular drawing of the heart. And admittedly, it's going to be hard to get a perspective on it, but we're looking from the anterior view. And specifically, this is the heart muscle right here, the myocardium. I'm going to erase that. And I know that's the left ventricle because the myocardium is so thick. The myocardium in the right atrium is right here. It's not very thick at all because it's only pumping blood directly into the right ventricle, which we can't see in this orientation of the heart. So that's myocardium of the right atrium. This is myocardium of the left ventricle. And I realize from this perspective, it looks like the left ventricle is immediately below the right atrium. It kind of sort of is, but it's not, if that doesn't make any sense. You don't have to memorize this picture. I just thought it was a great one. We see the aorta coming off the base of the heart, and that's actually taking blood directly from the left ventricle, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. Okay, so, and then over to the right in picture C is another really good depiction of really the mediastinum. The mediastinum is the region between the right and left lungs where the heart resides. And the only thing missing in picture C is the heart itself. Now the heart, which looks nothing like this, would sit in this space right there. And really what I want to focus on this picture is an outer layer right here, which is known as the fibrous pericardium. And we're gonna talk about that in detail. And then the middle picture, picture B, it's highlighting the serous membranes around the heart, which we discussed earlier in this semester when we were chatting about serous membranes, but we'll go over that again. So to get a good understanding of the layers of the heart, let's draw this out. Okay, so first, let's draw the myocardium. And the myocardium is quite thick. The myocardium is certainly the thickest layer of the heart. And I just want to highlight that what I'm drawing here is going to be the left ventricle. The left ventricle. What I'm drawing would apply to any chamber of the heart, but for simplicity, I'm going to represent this by the left ventricle. And I'm just going to do that in a different color. So we'll make the myocardium purple. Right there. And that's certainly the thickest layer of the heart. And that would correspond to this right here and that right there. Okay. So that white space is the opening of the left ventricle. That's where we would find blood. I shouldn't say the opening. It's the lumen or the space of the left ventricle. Occupying that space is going to be a very thin layer of simple squamous epithelial tissue. Simple squamous epithelial tissue. So we're going to put a lining of this right here. That is simple squamous epithelial tissue, and that's known as the endocardium. Endocardium, and I'm gonna write all these names down. It's mainly simple squamous epithelial tissue directly on top of a thin layer of connective tissue. And as we've learned, all epithelial tissue sits directly on connective tissue. So just so we're clear, it's in this space where we find blood within the left ventricle. So this is where all the blood would be. The blue line's the endocardium. The purple is the heart muscle known as the myocardium. Directly outside of the myocardium, we have another layer known as the epicardium. And the epicardium is just like the endocardium in that it is composed of simple squamous epithelial tissue directly on top of a layer of connective tissue. And this is gonna fold back on itself. And this may seem very familiar to you because we've talked about it. This is actually the serous membrane that is surrounding the heart. We talked about the serous membranes around the lungs and the abdominal cavity. So the one directly on top of the heart is the visceral pericardium. The one on the outside is the parietal pericardium. I will get back to that and I will label that. And then lastly, we have a tough, thick layer of connective tissue known as the fibrous pericardium, which is going to surround the heart something like this. So that's going to be the fibrous pericardium. Okay, let's go ahead and label all of this. So this blue line right here is the endocardium. And the endocardium in this picture A would be lining this region right here, lining the chambers of the heart. That is the endocardium. It's simple squamous epithelial tissue directly on top of a thin layer of connective tissue, mainly simple squamous epithelial tissue. The purple, let's get that in black. The purple layer is the myocardium. Myo refers to muscle, cardium refers to heart, so it is the heart muscle, and the great majority of the heart is the myocardium. It's the thickest layer of the heart. Inner blue line's endocardium, purple is myocardium, and now this blue line right here is the epicardium. Like the endocardium, it's made out of simple squamous epithelial tissue. Simple squamous epithelial tissue and a thin layer of connective tissue. So we have a blue line, a purple line, and another blue line. That is the endocardium, the myocardium, and epicardium, moving from interior to exterior. Endocardium, myocardium, and epicardium. The epicardium is also known as the visceral pericardium, which we just discussed and you all are familiar with because we talked about serous membranes at the beginning of the semester. So if that blue line is the epicardium, that makes this blue line, and I'm just writing it over here because there's more space over here, the parietal pericardium. Parietal pericardium. And that would make this space right, I have to to get a finer pen for this. Right here, the pericardial cavity. Pericardial cavity. And that's it. That's a region which we've had some challenges in describing where it is. The heart is not contained within the pericardial cavity. The pericardial cavity surrounds the heart. Specifically, it's between the visceral pericardium and the parietal pericardium. Once again, the visceral pericardium is the exact same thing as the epicardium. So from innermost to outermost, so far we have the endocardium, the myocardium, the epicardium, also known as the visceral pericardium, the pericardial cavity, and the parietal pericardium. And let's just also suggest that the pericardial cavity is that potential space because of the surface tension created by the pleural fluid. Those two layers stick together. When I say those two, the parietal and visceral layers stick together, and we'll say pericardial fluid. Okay, then the last layer is this green layer, which is the fibrous pericardium, which is that thick, dense layer of connective tissue. If we were able to look at the cadavers or look at a cadaver, you can actually see and touch the fibrous pericardium, and it is quite thick. It would be hard to rip with your hands. The parietal pericardium, visceral pericardium, endocardium are extremely fragile. So, innermost to outermost, endocardium, myocardium, epicardium, pericardial cavity, parietal pericardium, and the fibrous pericardium. Just to color code these, this right here on picture C is the fibrous pericardium. In blue over on picture A, we outlined the endocardium, but we could also show right, I'm going to need a thinner pen for this, right here is going to be the epicardium. And I'm trying not to make that too thick, because outside of that, actually looking at this picture, I'm not convinced that the fibrous pericardium is in that picture. So let's say directly on the outside of the myocardium is the epicardium. And then the picture in the middle, picture B, we can see the layers of the serous membranes. Okay, that's it for layers of the heart. This is Wednesday, April 8th, Corona 2020.